My name is Neeru Khera, and I have a production company called The Creative Gypsy, and we specialize in, like what our tagline says, specialize in filming dreams. But we have a specific thought behind every film that we like to put across a social message, but in an entertaining way. So we have made a couple of short films and a web series, which is called Section 377. And the three short films are all with the different directors, and all young directors. And two of them have been selected for representing the country at the Nice International Film Festival. And one of them has been selected for, you know, for being showcased and for the library at Cannes, because it was a little too long for the minimum time required. And the three films, short films, are Siri, the Living Scarecrow, and Aadha Chand Tum Rakh Lo, and Untold Story of Paper Boats. All three are about you know, specific parts of India, and all are topics which are of importance in these days. Like the Untold Story of Paper Boats talks about child soldiers and how children are drawn into Naxalism and how it affects their family and everything. And Amit Khanna is the writer and director of this film. And the other is called Aadha Chand Tum Rakh Lo, which has also been selected at Nice. And it is about secularism. It's about a friendship between a small Dalit boy and a Muslim older boy, and how they, you know, they don't have this Hindu-Muslim thing in them. And the Radha chant is a chant on Shivji's head, and how they share that chant, and they're very happy. And so it's beautifully shot in Varanasi. And this paper boats, though it's set in a Naxalite jungle, it was very difficult to go there. So we took a village in Haryana, and we tried to recreate that Naxalite infested area over here. And we've done a beautiful job. When you see it, you'll understand.
So you must sir, the murder was a creation behind the Untold Story of Paper Boat. Like, how did you come across the story?
Hi everyone, my name is Amit Khanna, and I've directed a short film called An Untold Story of Paper Boats, which is produced by Mrs. Neeru Khera, the creative gypsy. And well, Paper Boats is basically a subject which deals with child soldiering, and I strongly feel that this is a world related issue. It does not only affect India, but child soldiers are there everywhere, I mean in various other countries as well. I strongly believe that children are the future for tomorrow, and what they are taught from a very young age is what influences them, and they get molded in a particular way as you know, they have been told from a very early age. I feel that this is a topic which a lot of us should really consider, because it is, I think, very neglected, and that is why we feel that there has been a rise in terrorism in our in the world. And a lot of people are affected by it, a lot of innocent lives are lost, and at the end of the day, we don't really know whom to blame this for, because the people who become terrorists are, you know, are injected with a lot of negative thoughts right from a very early age. So Paper Boats is the story of this bright child who gets trapped in an Naxal camp, and how from becoming such a good student, he completely transforms, and you know, what leads him to the path of terrorism is what we've highlighted. Creative Gypsy has always, you know, brought up issues that affect not only a nation, but the whole world. And Paper Boats is a product of, you know, that very thought. And it is a, you know, it is a serious issue which we have dealt with, and I think it must be taken up seriously.
Okay, thank you, sir. You have shot this movie in just 3 days of time.
Yes.
So what was your experience behind it? Like, what came
about? I think, you know, both of us were there. She was there. This was the first time that, you know, she was there on the set. And I think she will tell you about how she felt. But it was definitely very, very challenging, because there are 200 village kids used in this film who have never faced a camera before. And teaching them how to not look into the camera, and we had rains, our entire set got washed out, we had to recreate it. I mean, I have done films earlier, so I know what one goes through, but it's more interesting if she tells about her experience, because it was...
Yes, it, you know, it was very exciting when we went there, and we thought it's going to be a very exciting thing, like you're going on a picnic, you're going to a village where there's a lake and, you know, greenery all around. But then we realized that for every small thing, if anything went wrong, we had to rush here and there, and you know, everything would stop, and you know, suddenly one day something would happen and suddenly it would rain too much, or it would become so hot that people would faint on the set. And you know, it's different in Delhi weather, and we shot it in July, so it is so hot and humid. One day it's going to rain so hard, and the other day it's going to be so sunny that you can't manage the heat. It's not like Mumbai or anything like that. And then, you know, like he said, it was very different, you know, making the people understand, especially the people of the village, you know, at one of the scenes, the whole village collected, you know, and they would keep running across, you know, and it was so difficult to make them understand. Then we had to hold like a kind of a workshop for them and tell them, see, now you're going to let this, and all of them were in the Haryanvi dress, you know. So then we had to explain, sometimes the cow would run across, sometimes the buffalo would run across, you know. So we had to tell them all that is okay. They said, you don't say anything to the buffalo, why do you get angry when we run across? We said the buffalo is the same in Bengal or in Haryana, but you people are not the same. So it was very funny also. And then, you know, we got all the local politicians, the Gram Panchayat people and all, and they all came and they said, we are the one who got everything arranged, we are the one, and they all wanted to be part of the film. So it was very, very different and challenging. And then there was a problem of electricity. There was no electricity. So we had to carry generators everywhere, and you know, huge trucks used to go with us with those lights and everything. And then mosquitoes in the middle of the night. And then, you know, there was a lot of insects.
Like, during the shoot, the insects would be in our eyes, nose, ears. It was very difficult.
And then, you know, everything was fine. We had to show some scenes of the paper boats flowing in the, you know,
lake.
And you know, there was so much of wind earlier, it was okay, but at night when we were shooting, it wouldn't move. There was not an inch of, you know, not a bit of wind, and the paperboard refused to move and we couldn't shoot. It was so difficult. We had to tie a string, one person had to go to the other side of the lake and to pull it in such a way so it seemed. So it was very exciting. And then suddenly, after doing the whole shot, you realize some man was standing over there and waving out right in one corner. And then the whole thing had to be shot, and we had to shout from here to get that person across. See, they were trying to help us, but it was so exciting. And you know, even in villages, they are very aware of camera and films, and they all asked us that you must tell us where it's going to come and how it is going to be there and how will we be there. And you know, they opened the school and everything. We got a lot of help in the beginning. They were a little they didn't want to give us, you know, license, you know, for because there was a couple of shooting scenes and all. And then, but then everything, we managed to use so much of the local people that, you know, sometimes when we see them and realize, oh, this man, you know, he's a typical Haryanvi, and here's like, he's a Naxalite. So we've done it was very exciting.
Sir, and madam, what was the most like memorable moment of the film during shoots?
During the shoot, I think it must have been definitely when we started it, because both of us really wanted to do this project from a very long time. So the day obviously when we began was memorable, but the most memorable one was when, you know, I got the mail and I called her up the first thing in the morning and told her that we are you know, showcasing at Cannes. I can never forget that moment, because that is the biggest moment for any filmmaker or any producer, and it was my dream from the past. I started my career as a filmmaker at the age of 18, and I'm 32 now, so it's been almost 14 years, and after 14 years, I'm going to Cannes. So I told her I can't believe it, though she's lucky because she's going within 8 months of starting off as a producer, and she's definitely like, it's obviously because of her passion, but yeah, that moment when we got the mail from Cannes was the most memorable moment, at least for me. Neeruji will share her moment.
Even I think the most memorable moment was when I gave the clap for the first time, you know, and those children were there. I love working with children, so it was like a dream come true. And you know, when I heard this script from Amit, from that first time I heard this script, I wanted to make it. And I told him, you know, that we will do it. And you know, because of the location, you know, and we had to go and shoot in places like this, so it was, you know, turning out to be very difficult. We could not, you know, understand how we would be able to do it, you know. So there were a lot of obstacles in the way, but I started something else, did something else, but I could keep coming back to this, you know, and I kept telling him that we will make it and we'll take it to Cannes. And you know, something, those things what you actually think and dream comes true and so fast, so it is unbelievable sometimes, you know. And representing the country is a great thing.
Really, it's a great achievement, huh. Sir. Madam, really congratulations for this achievement.
Thank
you. And sir, you'll be receiving the Dada Saheb Phalke Award.
Well, I have received the Dada Saheb Phalke Award yesterday. I have it with me. Surbhi, can you just get the award? Yes, basically yesterday evening I have received the Dada Saheb Phalke Award for excellence in fashion photography, and I'm really, really thankful to everyone who have you know, supported me through this journey, because I am the first person I've been told in fashion, in the fashion field or in fashion photography, to achieve such a prestigious award. And like we know, Dada Saheb Phalke was the first person who began you know, the film industry. So to receive it under his name is of you know, high prestige, and I'm really like overwhelmed. I'm so I was so nervous yesterday. I was telling her I could not even speak properly. So today I'm really grateful, and this is as good as getting any international award. But I think both of us are very excited, and we are really looking forward now for the Cannes and for the Nice, and we hope to make our country proud there.
Surely, sir. Reaching there in Cannes is really motivating India.
Reaching Cannes itself is an award,
yes.
But it will be great if we can get something back.
Surely.
And you know, see, not only this, it's been a very, very short journey for us, especially for me, you know. I have just come into this field about a year back. This is not my core business. I have a travel business. So I was always interested in this. But I think even we have set a record of sorts, because I don't think any other production house has managed to get two films from the same company at the same time in the same competition. So it's like two of my children competing for the same prize at the same time, you know. So, and we've got a lot of recognition. All three films are chosen for the Dada Saheb Phalke Film Festival in Delhi, which is going to be on the 30th. All three films are there. So I think this is also something very different and something which is not a common thing. And we got all three films got recognition at Los Angeles Film Festival. It has been screened at North Carolina Film, Cape Fear Film Festival. We have won awards at the Atharva Film Festival in Mumbai. We have won an award at Allahabad Film Festival, Prayag Film Festival, and it's been showcased all over. So I mean, one is okay, but all of them being showcased and all of them, you know, so. That's also a very big achievement.
In fact, the other film which is there, called Aadha Jaan Tum Rakh Lo, has been written and directed by a debut director, Mayank Bakolia. And even his, I think that film is wonderful. I kept on telling her that I had really loved the script. And Siri, which is called The Living Scarecrow, has been directed by Mr. Dabu Malik. So I think that, you know, all the three films have been doing so well. And, you know, any of them win at the end of the day, we'll have, you know, India win at any of these international festivals, and we are really hoping that we come back with flying colors.
Surely, sir, our prayers are with you. Our prayers are with you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For this. Yes, ma'am, what are your future plans working together?
Well, we are working on a few more web series. We are working on 2-3 more short films which are touching upon various issues again that our country is facing. They should be out by July, and then we will look forward to the second season of All About Section 377. You all can also check out the series on our YouTube channel, which is called The Creative Gypsy. We have been getting amazing comments, and the show has already started to pick up. Hence, we are looking forward to the season 2. So please get in touch with us if you want to be a part of it. And
subscribe to the channel, because we will be showcasing our short films also over there.
That's what we are looking
And we are planning something on a film on breast cancer, awareness of breast cancer. So we are planning a very serious project on that. Let's see how we go about it.
Well, I think that this particular channel has one of the best camera people, because they make all of us look really good, and the video goes up so quickly.
Yes.
And it's really amazing to you know, see how quick the edit is, how quick you know, he shoots it. And we also look, you know, we also have subscribed to the channel on YouTube as well as on Facebook, on Twitter as well. We are following Viral Bollywood, and we would request all the viewers to continue watching to spread the word, because I think that you all really are fast and furious.
Did
you
great job.
I mean, thank you so much, first of all, for interviewing the two of us and asking us such relevant questions and helping us to spread awareness. I really wish you all the best and really hope that next time you're sitting with us on this side and not hiding behind the camera.
And I think, and when we come back with a award, I think you'll be the first people we'll get in touch with.
We'll be happy to do that.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.